Oh, thanks.
Oh,
would you go back to the car and get that pumpkin pie
and
let's back?
Hey, whoa! Is that your little boy, Tommy?
Yeah.
How old's he now?
Gonna be 6. They grow up. Party's fun for them.
Yeah. Safer than letting them go door to door these days, ain't it? You got any?
Nah.
You?
Hi.
We're working on it.
You're in Waco?
Yeah, Operation Trojan Horse. You?
Nah, I missed that one.
I didn't think I recognized you. Phil Sachs.
Randy Jackson.
It's good to meet you.
Good to meet you.
So, where are you from? Did you just transfer in or something?
Now you're gonna answer to God.
How does the murder of an ATF agent get to be Lindsay Strauss's name?
Why not Lindsay Strauss?
Because she hardly has any experience in violent crimes whatsoever.
That's my point. I want to vary the assignments and build up the team.
Michael, this is a high-profile murder case. I hardly think now's the time to experiment with management policy.
But I think she's ready. I think she's earned it. And if you're concerned about her, watch her back.
Me?
You just elected yourself, John.
Morning. What do we got?
Okay. Randy Jackson, 34 years old. His criminal record's pretty clean. He's got a couple of driving raps, a drunk and disorderly up in Rockland County. But he did spend 6 months in a psychiatric unit for violent paranoid syndrome.
Is he saying anything?
Can't shut him up. He's proud of what he did. By the time the other agents grabbed him, he was already bragging.
You shoot an agent point-blank range.
In the face.
It's an execution makes you a big star.
Payback for the executions at Waco. His words.
His last words, if we do our jobs right.
This Waco noise, does it connect them to any group? You hear about it from a lot of crazies.
I've been talking to Schindler. He's the guy downstairs that monitors the fringe right, the militias.
Yeah, I know he is. I gave him the job. What is he saying?
He says that Jackson's a loner. By the way, Michael, Schindler kind of feels that this case should have been his.
That's okay. It's fine. He feels that way. It's your case. Now, keep him looking. Let's bring on Dawson. And has Jackson taken on an attorney yet?
Waived. He'll go court-appointed.
A loner? No lawyer? And he confesses? Did I hear anybody say we get to go home early?
Is this the victim?
Yeah.
ATF agent Sachs. You okay?
No. He and his wife were trying to have a baby for a long time.
You want me to get somebody else?
No, let's do it.
So there was a building filled with ATF agents. Why did you pick Mr. Sachs?
Just hanging out, enjoying his beer. One of those butchers from Waco. I know. You want me feeling all guilty and bad about this? You think Agent Sachs was eating his guts out over those women and children burned at the stake out there? You think anybody in the occupying forces called our government has lost any sleep over a woman shot in the face, son shot in the back up there at Ruby Ridge? Government never paid for those sins. We decided it was time to pay for them.
When you say we, who are you talking about?
Decent folks, sweetie.
Were you working with someone?
You see anybody else here? Those agents that grabbed me, felt me up, they see anybody else that night?
So you just woke up one morning and said, I'm gonna get me an ATF agent today?
That's right, sugar. And I'm working my way up the list.
Be careful.
I'm a sovereign citizen of Rockland County, the Republic of New York. I don't recognize you or your laws or your government because your government no longer exists. So what you do to me doesn't mean a thing.
What I do to you may come as a surprise.
You think you can scare me? I looked that boy from ATF right in the eyes. Then there was nothing but a bloody hole. It was outstanding. I'll do it again, Mr. U.S. Attorney.
You look surprised. You're in my house now.
Doesn't look like much of a life, does it?
Yeah, we have this in my apartment.
So Michael's wondering whether this guy's really working alone.
Come on, you got a head full of ideas. You want to share them.
Hey, Eddie, what do you got?
Pentium 2 processor with 48 megabytes of RAM and a 6 gig hard drive.
Well, that's what we're looking for. He must be sharing.
Okay, can we pull every file? I want to see what's in them.
It's going to take a while. I'm going to have to haul this all back to the lab.
Okay. Bingo! Kennedy conspiracy. Gulf War shows, gun control.
Gulf War shows.
United Nations.
Profiles in cowardice.
Major genocides of this century have always been preceded by gun control. First thing a tyrannical government ever does is to disarm its own subject citizens. You look that up in your history books. And when found, make a note of it. Show it to your friends.
When found, make a note of it. Well, I can tell you who that is. H. Booth Parker, bona fide hate monger and windbag extraordinaire.
Yeah, I've heard of him.
So this guy is far right leaning?
H. Booth doesn't lean right. He falls right through it, comes out the other side.
Okay, Schindler.
He calls black people Canaanites. That's after the mark of Cain. He says Hitler had some wrong ideas, but mostly just had bad press, and we all know who controls the press. And as for those ovens over in Auschwitz, well, seems a team of mechanics from Tennessee snuck in and had a look, and guess what? Turns out they'd never been turned on in the first place. Stop me when you get the idea.
So Tennessee, this guy broadcasts from Tennessee?
You'd think so. He has a studio on 10.
Says he has to have his hocks and beans airlifted to the roof of his building. Ha ha. Actually, he's known to frequent a deli on 9th.
Eddie.
Tape you missed, ladies. From the dashboard of Randy's pickup.
Mike.
Bill.
Angelosi.
How you doing?
All right, how are you?
Still with the 6-3?
Oh, yeah. We're all real proud of you over there, Mike.
Yeah, I appreciate that. You here to see me?
Yeah. We, step over here for a second, please?
Sure.
Michael, your brother's been showing up with some, surveillance photos.
You following Danny?
No, we're, watching Frank Kosick. He's, connected with the people down
there. Yeah, I know he is.
Kosick and your brother have been fraternizing some. I thought I owed it to you.
You doing anything?
No, not yet.
If he does anything, you pop him. I don't want any favors.
I appreciate you not putting me in that position.
I appreciate the information. How's Angela?
Oh, she's great. She got a real estate license.
Yeah.
Michael, we're popping Kosick next couple of days.
Okay. Appreciate it, Bill.
Okay, man.
I'll talk to you later.
Take care.
Thanks.
Yeah. Okay, I need to explain something first. Every week, H. Booth Parker does a segment on his show called Profiles in Cowardice, which is, it's basically just a chance to bash whatever group Booth happens to hate at the moment. I mean, a couple of weeks ago, it was the IRS. Last week, it was the crusading environmentalists.
Parker did a segment on the ATF.
Right.
At their annual Halloween bash. Right up there in Westchester County. Just leave the Statue of Liberty behind, turn left up the Hudson River. Now, how is that to turn your stomachs? ATF agents out with their families. Of course, they still have their families. They weren't burned at the stake in Waco or Ruby Ridge. So,
when did this make
you? Night before Agent X was killed.
Give me a call. Hello, this is H. Booth Parker on the air.
Hey, Booth. It's Randy.
Randy? Hey. Thought maybe the UN shipped you out to Siberia.
Some days it feels that way.
So, you calling about those ATF agents, Randy?
Those killers never paid for what they did out there.
That's because our government thinks they don't have to obey the law like you and I do. You think that's fair, Randy?
Hell no, it's not fair.
You gonna do something about it, Randy? Because tomorrow is the day. It's supposed to be a beautiful fall day.
Well, I'll do something.
Be like shooting fish in a barrel if you did. Because that's what we got up there in Westchester County tomorrow. And it's what they got coming, God's truth.
God's truth.
Okay, can I have my next caller?
Hello, H. Booth?
Yes, ma'am. Who am I talking to?
God's truth.
nail Booth Parker for conspiracy to commit murder. I mean it. Why not?
Why not? Because you've got a conviction, no contest on Randall Jackson for murder one. You don't want to muddy the water.
The water is already muddied. That's not it.
Then what is it?
As irresponsible as Parker is being, he is exercising his freedom of expression.
He was calling for and procuring the murder of federal officials.
He made a speech, and every letter of it is protected by the First Amendment. You will recall Brandenburg versus Ohio.
Klansmen calling for violence against blacks and Jews. The Supreme Court backed their rights to the hilt.
It's irrelevant. In the first place, they weren't on the phone talking one-on-one to a fanatic, telling him where and when to strike. In the second place, they weren't up against you.
That's shameless.
Shameless, yet brilliant.
Take a look at this material that Schindler's gathered. These people are a nationwide plague, and they're not all talk. They've been linked to church burnings, attacks on federal property, hate crimes. There are 8-10 states weighing criminal actions against them. Civil rights violations, incitement to violence. But you know what? They're afraid. Because the legal ground hasn't been broken yet.
Yet?
The hit was imminent. We have criminal conspiracy at the very least.
I don't think so. If it's anything, it's murder. Criminal Code, Section 2, Paragraph B, cause an act to happen and you commit that act.
So, you're saying Parker committed a murder?
That's what I'm saying.
What do we need?
What do we need? Knowledge. Parker had to know that his words were going to cause murder, which means he had to know Randy Jackson.
Randy Jackson was a regular caller.
Not good enough. He's just a voice in the darkness. We know he had a violent record. But did Parker?
Why? How would he?
I don't know, but if we can't figure that out, we have no case.
Exactly.
Okay, what else?
Intent. Parker had to want his words to cause murder. If we can't prove that, all we have is reckless endangerment at best.
He had to want Sachs dead.
Right, or a colleague.
So, anything else we can think of to make this more difficult?
I'll let you know. We proceed against Parker without burning down the First Amendment to get him. We move forward with extreme caution or not at all. Are we agreed? Let's do it.
I don't know how much Parker knew about Randy, but Randy knew a lot about him. He was the president of his fan club.
El Presidente, huh?
And treasurer. I guess you got to double up like that when you only got 6 members.
Where do these groups meet?
No, that's an old-fashioned fan club, Michael. Meetings took place in cyberspace.
So these meetings must have had Parker's blessing.
They probably had no idea. There's tons of Parker fan clubs on the internet. It's completely unregulated out there.
What are these?
The only real personal effects we found. Handwritten letters.
From somebody named Tylene, no last name. Well, it's a start. Can I take these?
Be my guest. Michael, I mean, so the guy's a big-time Booth Parker fan. Hey, I liked Anthony Hopkins a lot in Silence of the Lambs. Doesn't mean I'm heating up the fava beans.
See, there's a fine line between being a talk show bigot and being David Koresh. I think Booth Parker crossed that line when he heated up Randy Jackson. Let's check out these fan clubs, see if he had any contact with them.
You got it.
Tylene, hi. I'm Lindsay Strauss from the U.S. Attorney's Office.
When's Randy's trial gonna be?
There's not gonna be a trial. He pleaded guilty. He's just awaiting sentencing now.
In the jail?
I heard that he's refused to let you see him there.
Yeah, well, he doesn't want me to see him caged up like an animal. You know, so that's the reason.
Well, you're his girlfriend, right?
Funny thing to call it.
What would you call it?
His lover. His woman.
Tylene, before the judge passes sentence on Randy, if there's anything at all that you can think of to tell us...
Don't even.
Excuse me?
Like I gotta stand here and tell you anything?
Tylene, my bossy U.S. attorney, Michael Hayes, hasn't asked for the death penalty on Randy yet. You wanna know why? Because we think that somebody else may have told Randy what to do. And he's waiting for me to find out. Now, is there anything at all that you can tell me about that?
Randy doesn't want me talking about that. Or anything.
Tylene, you can help him.
Like I would really ever do anything that Randy told me not to. I'm his girlfriend. Remember?
Hey, Booth. It's Randy.
Randy? Hey. Thought maybe the UN shipped you out to Siberia.
Some days it feels that way.
Still doesn't prove they knew each other.
Michael, I've gone back 4 weeks and he's taped 6 calls Randy's made with the same familiarity.
Exactly. That's the tone he uses for his callers. How long do you think you need on the tapes?
2.5 years worth.
Okay, we've got to move quick. Yes, sir.
I picked up something online while surfing the militia chat rooms.
Translate?
Okay, 6 months ago, Jackson arranged a speaking engagement for Booth Parker at a local high school.
Okay, if they met and he knew him, we're halfway home.
It didn't happen. It got canceled at the last minute.
What I'm trying to determine, Mr. Irwin, is why the speaking engagement was canceled.
I don't remember.
But you do all of Booth Parker's publicity, right?
Well, sure, but, you know, Booth's a busy man. We got him going all over the place. Even Hollywood later this month. Boy, that ought to be interesting, huh?
Okay. Randall Jackson contacted you, tried to set this up. Is that correct? All right, let me diagram a case I see developing against you and your station.
Against me? For what?
Your guy goes on the air, incites somebody to commit a murder, and you don't prevent him. Now, from where I'm sitting, that's accessory to murder.
Hey, let's not go overboard, okay? I mean... Look, it's a scary world out there, and, you know, a public figure like Booth, he's gotta know what he's stepping into.
So you're the point man, right? You check this thing out before he goes in?
Yeah, and the Rockland thing sounded good, but we didn't know anything about this Jackson guy, so we checked him out.
Checked him out?
Yeah, you know, it seems he had some problems.
What do you mean, problems?
Mental hospital, a violent ward. I don't remember specifics, but the very word violent and the very word mental, frankly, we were afraid he might hurt Booth.
So you and Parker knew that he had mental problems when you were dealing with him?
Yeah, that's why we canceled it. He wasn't happy about it, but we didn't want Booth's ass shot off by some wacko.
As Mr. Parker's counsel, we both agreed to help with whatever this is, Mr. Hayes.
Okay, then I'll come right to the point.
An ATF agent was murdered by a man named Randall Jackson.
I'm aware, naturally. Grim stuff.
Mr. Jackson was a caller on your radio show the night before it happened.
The FBI and I have been over this.
You were having a discussion about killing ATF agents.
Now, I'm going to have to stop you right there. If you're trying to connect my client in any way with the shooting of that ATF agent...
Mr. Seward, I am merely trying to determine what happened.
And I will tell you what I know, which is nothing. I get hundreds of calls, and even if I possessed all the powers of Solomon, I couldn't begin to know who's on the other end.
Now, I think you'd remember this one. You were encouraging him to kill an ATF agent. I believe the phrase you used was like shooting fish in a barrel.
Wouldn't be the first time I've said that. And that doesn't mean that I actually wanted somebody to go out and shoot.
Booth, I'm going to have to...
I'm talking now. See, I am an entertainer, Mr. Hayes. My job is to provide good radio, and that means stimulating, provocative, dramatic interaction with my guests and my callers.
Even at the cost of someone's life?
You can't begin to prove that.
ATF. You know what the ATF is to me?
What's that?
Bunch of lawless goons. A threat to American freedoms, but thanks to this great country, I am allowed to say that. Unless free speech has now gone the same way as two-parent families.
Okay, let me just cut to the chase then. Do you, Mr. Parker, know Randall Jackson personally?
You're asking me if I know one of several million people who listen to my show?
That's what I'm asking you.
Hell no.
Okay. Thanks for stopping by, gentlemen.
The defense will remind you, and they will be accurate, that freedom of speech is protected by the Bill of Rights, and that on any given night, Mr. H. Booth Parker can spew out his hate-filled, venomous words to unknown listeners, inciting criminal acts, and his use of those words is sacred under the Bill of Rights. But you know, that's not why he's here today. He's here today because he is on trial for some very specific words geared to a very specific listener to create a very specific act. An ATF agent must die. That was Mr. Parker's message to Randall Jackson. We will prove that he was certain Mr. Jackson would not only respond, but obey. And why? Because of his extreme nature, because of his devotion to Mr. Parker, and because of his violent behavior. Randall Jackson is the gun that Mr. Parker pointed at an agent from the United States Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. An agency that he's had a long-standing and open hostility toward. Mr. Parker pointed Randall Jackson at Agent Philip Sachs and pulled the trigger, terminating Agent Sachs's career, his marriage, and his life in cold blood. And there is nothing sacred about that. Thank you.
This is a frightening day. The government of the United States, your government, is charging Booth Parker with murder, the most grievous offense in our land, because of something he said on the radio one night. That's shocking, because we have fundamental rights in this country, and the first one up on that list is the right to free speech. Now, somehow, the government has forgotten that. And they dragged Booth Parker into this courtroom like a common criminal. I'm sure many of you have heard Rush Limbaugh call his enemies feminazis, or maybe you've heard Howard Stern go so far as to say that he hopes the head of the FCC gets a terrible disease and dies. So you see, if you find Booth Parker guilty, you may have to find a lot of other people guilty too, because the airways of this country are filled with vigorous, colorful, and, yeah, sometimes downright offensive words and ideas, which is just the way the Founding Fathers wanted it. Don't think it'll stop here. Everyone in this courtroom will soon be at risk. Whenever you say whatever it is you feel like saying. Because if the government can do this to Booth Parker with all his support and ample resources, just think what the government can do to you.
Mr. Irwin, as producer of the Booth Parker show, you've enjoyed some success.
Well, counting numbers of carriers, total signal, he's third or fourth shock jock in the Northeast.
Congratulations. And I think we can assume that being connected to the death of Agent Sachs hasn't hurt your ratings any.
Objection, Your Honor. Sustained.
Fair enough, Your Honor. Recalling the first week of February 1995, I believe you scored your highest ratings to date. Can you tell me what the subject of that show was?
Relevance, unless the subject of those shows was the murder we're here to try.
I'll allow it, provided your purpose becomes clear, Mr. Hayes.
I will do my best, Your Honor. Thank you.
Witness will answer.
Those were the bomb shows. Booth told people how to make bombs at home.
Bomb shows? As in small, easy to carry, easy to hide, potentially in a government office bombs? I'll withdraw. Moving along. If I could, Your Honor, I'd like to enter what is marked Government Exhibit 4. Would you take a look at that, Mr. Irwin? Tell me what that is.
That's the weekly schedule form that we give to Booth.
And does it not document his cancellation of the speaking engagement in Rockland County? Mr. Irwin?
Yes.
Thank you.
Now, you say the reason you canceled the speaking engagement was because the organizer, whom you had never met, was dangerous and crazy.
Well, that's what my staff told me. And looks like they were right from what happened.
Well, so they told you and you told Booth.
Well, it's here on the schedule form.
I see the little note at the bottom. How many notes or schedules, memos, written or verbal, do you give your star in the course of a day? 4 or 5?
20.
Well, say 10. That's 5 days a week. That's a couple hundred a month. In other words, 1,000 since that time. Do you believe, Mr. Irwin, that Booth Parker, after 6 months, could remember that a caller had been in the hospital because it says so on a little slip of paper?
Thank you.
Mike.
Whoa.
Wow, this is cool.
My dad got me this. It's really cool.
Yeah. You see a game like this, you gotta get it, right?
He shoots, he scores. Espo gets the hat trick.
Danny. It's a school night.
How much fun is this guy, huh? Come on, go get your stuff.
You can get ready?
Okay.
Hey. You three are going to a wedding, huh?
Yeah. Caitlin's cousin invited us.
Do I have to learn how to dance?
That's up to your mother.
That sounds really fun. A wedding?
Yeah. Somebody that I used to work with came by to see me the other day.
So what, do you like her escort?
Frank Kozik. Frank Kozik, Danny, is a direct line back to the joint. Is that what you want?
You got someone following me, Mike?
You listening to me?
Mike, look, I don't want your life, all right? I never have, and I never will. And Caitlin knew that when she married me.
Ready?
Pete, he is ready.
Ready?
You ready? You do your homework?
Yeah.
Your hockey homework. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Okay, let's go. Do we have any proof of this?
Yes. Janet had the FBI in Cleveland up all night verifying.
But Tylene knows nothing about it.
My guess is nothing at all.
Okay, there's your leverage. Use it.
Michael, she trusts me.
Better. Where is she?
She's in the conference room. Listen, what we need here...
What we need here is to prove that Jackson is a disciple of Parker.
Well, that's not going to happen, because Randy told her not to go there. He's protecting his idol, H. Booth Parker, to the death. Give me something to deal. Let me tell her that we'll seek consideration from his sentencing judge if she cooperates.
No deal. Whatever Parker is, Jackson is still a murderer.
Michael, we haven't filed on penalty yet.
Gotta make it work.
Michael.
You can do this. You don't need a deal.
What's that for? Think I'm gonna change my mind about talking to you?
No. No, we understand. Randy's your guy.
Well, all right then.
So, did he let you come and see him in jail yet?
No.
No, he still has that thing about not wanting you to be hurt seeing him like that?
Yeah, that's Randy, you know? Always thinking about me instead of himself.
Sure. Tylene, I have something that I have to tell you. Maybe you know it already. I'm hoping that you do.
Know what?
That Randy's married to a woman in Ohio where he's from.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he told me. So, but it's not that big of a deal.
Good.
Yeah, I mean, doesn't mean that he doesn't love me.
Janet, would you? It's off. Well, I'm impressed, Tylene. You're standing by him, even with him lying to you and all. I can tell that you didn't know, Tylene.
Well, it doesn't mean I'm not going to stand by him.
Well, that's good news, because his life is in your hands.
Your boss decided to ask for the death penalty? Wait, are you telling me that Randy's gonna die?
Tylene, do you want to help him?
So, if I help you, then Randy won't die?
I guess it's just lucky that Randy fell in love with you, huh? Not someone who's gonna keep her mouth shut just because he tells her to, even if it means he ends up on death row.
Death row.
Come on, Tylene. Come on. You gonna help us? You gonna tell us what we want to know?
What do you want to know?
Were there times that Randy said anything at all about Parker? His
his feelings for him, his willingness to follow him.
I thought you wanted to know about the time that they met.
So, I've been in with Tylene, and, we have a witness.
Good.
Yeah. So, isn't it time for this thing?
It's that time.
Well, I'm sure you're all keeping up with grisly details. My daily persecution by the occupation force known as the United States government. They do hold the key to the gulag system known as the federal penitentiary. Recruiting ground for UN members and other roving sodomites. But the good news is I will be judged by a jury of my peers. People just like you and me who are thinking to themselves, what the hell kind of a three-ring circus is this? What in God's name has happened to this country? And yet this Michael Hayes, the U.S. attorney, they really pulled out the big Harvard-educated guns for this one. Michael Hayes trying to convince 12 decent Americans that I told one of my listeners to go out and commit murder. And he went right out and did it just because I said so. Now, how ridiculous is that, people? That's about as ridiculous as me saying that Michael Hayes is public enemy number one and he doesn't deserve to live. Now let's see what happens. Let's see if somebody goes out and kills a U.S. attorney just because I said so. I will be waiting by the phone.
Your Honor, the FBI has informed you of the defendant's broadcast last night.
I was awakened at an inappropriate hour, yes.
Your Honor, the government requests that the defendant be remanded to jail as a danger to the community and in particular to the United States attorney.
Granted forthwith. Bailiff will take him into custody at the end of today's session.
Your Honor.
Open your mouth, and I play the tapes for the jury.
Mr. Parker, we've all heard now about your memory defects and the identity of callers slipping your mind, even if they are the president of your fan club.
Well, I've got more than one fan club. I've got seven, they tell me, all unofficial.
It's a big number. Have you ever had any personal contact with one of these groups?
I do a few personal appearances, but mainly I'm just a voice in the night speaking to them about what they care most about.
Not on the radio now, sir.
How this country has lost its way.
Mr. Parker.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. That's something that I feel very deeply about, just like my listeners do. And we won't be shut up as easily as some people would like.
Fair enough. So you've never had contact with any of the officials of these groups, say, Mr. Randall Jackson?
No. It sounds as if it's a good thing I didn't, seeing as he's turned out so crazy.
But you wouldn't know that because you've never met him, right?
No.
Never looked in the man's eyes, seen his potential for violence or evil?
I told you no.
Not that you would consider executing a 38-year-old man in service of his country evil, mind you.
Now, who is on the air, Mr. Hayes?
You don't ask the questions, Mr. Parker.
Let's talk about Harburg's, Mr. Parker, if you don't mind.
Harburg's, a restaurant?
Yes, Harburg's, the delicatessen where you eat lunch every day. At Harburg's.
Well, I do. Sid Harburg's a nice Jewish fellow. He knows what I want, makes it special for me.
Isn't this the same Harburg's where Randall Jackson confronted you for canceling that speaking engagement? Isn't that right? He waited outside because he knew you'd be there. You eat lunch there every day. He knew you'd be there. So he waited outside in his pickup truck.
He just came in. Jackson got the death penalty. Mr. Parker?
Lots of fans come up to me on the street every day.
But do you get in their vehicles? Is that a common practice? What was it that you and Mr. Jackson talked about that day in the pickup truck?
I never got into his pickup.
You never? Tylene Charters, Mr. Jackson's girlfriend, admitted that you and he spoke for over a half an hour that day.
I wouldn't. Why would I get into a car with a crazy man?
That's a good question, and that's my point. Why would you?
But at the time.
At the time, go on. At the time, you got into his truck because you knew he was crazy and you were worried about how angry he was. Angry at you. Well, didn't you meet Tylene Charters, Mr. Parker, the day you met Randall Jackson? Didn't you call him
your soldier and that he should wait for your call. Didn't you do that, Mr. Parker? Why? Ratings?
Objection, Your Honor!
Sustained.
Your right to ask me that question.
Sustained.
I don't recognize this court.
Mr. Your Honor!
Its sovereignty, its Booth. Jurisdiction.
Mr. Hayes!
Do you recognize this? Mr. Parker, this is a wedding ring. It symbolizes a partnership. This is Mrs. Philip Sachs, who no longer has a partner because of you.
Objection, Your Honor. This
Bill of Rights protects your right to spew your insanity, but it does not give you the right to execute people on the radio.
That is
enough. Objection, Your Honor.
I'm through. Mr. Hayes, I will have order in this court. I will hold you in contempt.
Lindsay. Listen, congratulations. I didn't think you had it in you.
You know, I didn't think I had it in me either. I'm sorry. I suppose that was meant as a compliment.
Of course it was.
Strauss. Randy's gonna die.
Yeah, I know. I am so sorry.
You're sorry? Sorry's gonna die or sorry you lied to me? You said if I help, it wasn't gonna happen.
No. I didn't
say. No, I don't believe you! I never believed you! Oh, you people!
Right. That's enough. Come on, let's go outside.
No, he's gonna die! He's gonna die! He hates me! He hates me and he's gonna die because I let him down.
Come on.
You lied!
No!
I'm okay. I'm okay.
Yeah, you are.
I am. I mean, I'm okay.
Yeah, you are.
Has the jury reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
Please rise. Mr. Foreman, to the indictment, one count of murder, how do you find the defendant?
We find the defendant guilty.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, the court thanks you for your service in this matter. You are excused.
Parker's sentence is 15 years.
Mm-hmm.
We got what we wanted. I should be thrilled, right? I just keep seeing Tylene's face.
Well, here's the other way to think about it. We went against the Supreme Court ruling with the First Amendment hanging in the balance, and you made it work. That's a big deal. You got to let yourself have this one.
I want to talk to the DA. I want to get her some slack.
It's your call.
Okay.
Karen Sachs wanted you to know that it turned out. They managed after all. She's pregnant.
want to know right, left, and now push back.
I don't want to.
Now, come on, a properly raised young man needs to know how to do this.
She's right.
Yeah, but I don't get it.
Michael, will you show him, please?
All right. By the way, I think if you learn, you're going to like it.
Not I won't.
Get it. But it's not worth fighting about, am I right?
Peanut Danny, watch us how we do it, okay?
Just easy.
And you alone were meant for me. Please give your love.
Worse than heart.
No. Nice. I'm about to teach you too.
Oh boy.
And say we'll never part.
Danny, you watching?
I think of you.
Are you watching?
Dream of you every night. Darling, I'm never lonely.
Come back.
Whenever you are inside, I love you.
Another one.
For sentimental reasons. I hope you do believe me. I've given you my heart.